Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Unreal Tips and Tricks. Today, we're going to go over 5 tips for brand new users who are coming from other digital content creation platforms. The first tip is about locating content in your content browser. If you start a blank project, you'll notice you have nothing in the content browser. However, there is a floor, there's default materials. So where do these assets live? If you open up the tree view in your content browser and go down here to view options, you can enable by showing engine content and show plugin content. This will give you access to the inbuilt engine content. If you picked a blank project and you later wanted to go back and add a first person blueprint or something like that, you can use this add new button and add feature a content pack. Here you can get access to the blueprint features that you may have skipped when you first created the project, or you can also add the starter content if you didn't add it at the beginning. The second tip is about the asset editor open location. What this is whenever you open up an asset, it will usually populate windows in front of your viewport. For instance, if I open up editor preferences, I get this window here. And if I open up project settings, I get another window that's tabbed on it. But what actually controls how this works is this asset editor open location, which is set to default. You can change this so it would be last docked or new window, meaning wherever I last docked a window, that's where I'd like to open up the next window. So if I were to close project settings and reopen it, it should dock and tab in the same place as the previously opened window. This can help if you have multiple monitors and don't want windows constantly spawning in front of your viewport. The next tip is about viewport navigation. If you're coming from another DCC, you may not be used to the WASD game controls that are typically used in Unreal. And if you use your alt navigation, you may find that the pan is backwards of what you thought. Perhaps the camera doesn't orbit the same way. Luckily, these settings are easily changed inside editor preferences. If you go to edit, editor preferences, go down into the viewports option, there's a checkbox for invert middle mouse pan, as well as a checkbox for orbit around selection. I also like use distance scaled camera speed. This can help when you're going through scenes that have lots of large objects, you'll move faster, and then when you're on lots of tightly packed smaller objects, you'll move slower. This should help your navigation and help you get up to speed a little bit quicker. The next tip is a little bit about performance. There's various stat commands you can use to monitor your FPS, but there's actually another way as well. If you go to Edit, Editor Preferences, Performance, and then use the checkbox to show frame rate and memory, you can see your FPS counter and your memory usage in the top right at all times. This use less CPU when in background checkbox is also helpful to tick off if you're swapping between applications and you're noticing frame drop. By default, it should be checked on, as Unreal will try not to use all the CPU when it's not the focused application. The last tip is about keyboard shortcuts. If I create a new asset, like a widget blueprint, and I want to duplicate this, by default, it's Control W. This is not the same keyboard shortcut that I use in other applications, but luckily this is easy to change. If I go to Edit, Editor Preferences, and then go down to the keyboard shortcuts, I can search for what I'm looking for, in this case, duplicate. I can change it from Control W to Control D, and easily maintain the same hotkeys across different applications. I hope you found these tips and tricks for new users to be helpful, and I hope to see you on another episode of Unreal Engine Tips and Tricks.